dear friends, welcome to Shiksha Mantra. Once again, I'd like to thank you for the love and care you have actually shared with me in developing my channel a bit. So, this is your love and care. This is your inspiration that every day inspires me to bring more videos for you. But unfortunately, I was a bit down because my throat was a bit down and I couldn't bring a new video for you for a long time. Whatever it may be, still the problem is continuing. But how can I stay away from my dear viewers, subscribers and students? So I've decided that with the problem, I would start discussing in my YouTube channel in some short videos. Now the videos won't get longer than 5 or 6 minutes and I won't drag them long and to go into the details, but I would start discussing them in part. So the first discussion of this short series today is about, yes, as you have found it out where in the title, and this is about the key factors of personal letters. Yes, dear friends, letter writing, though nowadays might be considered as a lost art. We must say that letter writing is a lost art now, but it's not a lost, it's a better to consider it not as a lost art, but a classical art, that I would rather say. Because nowadays we don't write down letter. We have SMS, we have emails and many other chat boxes, WhatsApp, whatever it may be. We have so many options nowadays, but we must remember another factor, that letter writing has actually not lost its classical touch. But at the same time, there's another problem, that still in your exam you are asked to write down a letter. So how to handle a personal letter? I'll discuss them in very short. I'll only bring some very vital points for you to decide and to remember and to use. The first thing, personal letter, just focus on the term, it's personal letter. So it maintains a personal relation, a relation in between the writer and the reader. One who is writing and one who is reading the letter. So who is in the sender side and who is in the receiver side, their relation is the level of personal relation that you must maintain in your letter. How it is? Whenever we write down a personal letter, we write down only to those people who are very close to us, like our friends, brothers, sisters, father or mother, and sometimes to our relatives. But if you consider this, those people whom we write a personal letter are very close to our heart. So, seldom we maintain formality with them. But when we are talking face to face, they're getting formal or informal, it's easier. But when you are writing down something, how to manage it? For this, you must remember that in English, we have two different types of languages to be used, two different types of dictions, vocabulary, construction, so many things. So first, what you have to do here, you have to use informal construction, informal English, informal ways of speaking. So don't write down very formal sentences when you are writing to your friend, because in actuality you don't talk to your friend with much formality. You don't get so much formal when you talk to your friend or to your brother or sister or to your cousins. So There, you have to use informal words and informal construction. What is formal and informal? We already have discussed it in a video in this channel only. So you may follow the link and you'll find out the difference between formal and informal English and what is formality and what is informality and how to maintain this. But the point is you have to get informal. Okay. So if we first think, what is the problem of writing down a letter? When you have been asked to write down a letter, the first problem you face that what to write, from where to begin. You fail to find out a perfect position, a perfect sentence with which you would begin this letter. And what you do, you start with some, you begin with some very common expressions, those expressions which are getting actually so much familiar that nowadays we consider them to be outdated. Like, I have just received your letter, you have asked me about something, blah blah blah, etc. Or how are you, how is your parents, etc, etc. I don't like those expressions to be used in a personal letter. Why? Because here I would ask you to read one very extraordinary essay, and that is The Art of Letter Writing. So how would Carlyle write down a letter? According to Carlyle, a letter would be peculiar skill. It must be such that when someone reads them, he would find them not as written sentences but as a live demo. He would find it to be a film, a movie, and not a letter. So this is the quality of personal letter that you have been asked, you have been expected. Your writing would be such that the person who is reading this letter would find everything to be very much live. Suppose you are writing down to your friend regarding your visit to a nearby park. So you would start, it's a fine morning, I was suddenly wake up, and the sun was just rising, the color of the sky was so much enchanting that I couldn't hold me back onto my bed. I jumped up, I get ready and run to a nearby park. The speciality of the park is that here a beautiful lake is there. There's a very beautiful lake, and I do want to observe the sky, the red sky with the rising sun on the backdrop of a lake. So it's your emotion, it's your sudden outburst of emotion that would make the things. You are writing down personal letter, and in personal level, most of the time you break laws. So why not in your letter? Break laws in your letter. Make everything very simple. Keep everything very simple. You don't produce much complex or compound sentences with your parents, with your friends, with your cousins, with your brothers and sisters. What do you do there? You use fragmented sentences, just colloquial touches there. You don't get much formal. Most of the time you break rules of formality when you are talking to a friend, when you are talking to a brother or sister. So bring that quality into your letter and it will do. So don't fix yourself. Don't think that when I am writing down a personal letter, I have to use these expressions. I have to make salutations, etc, etc, etc. Those are just formalities which you'd have to manage. But don't begin your letter, don't start your letter with these fixed expressions, because they mar the spirit of your letter. And I don't think that with these very stereotyped letters that you most of the time find in some books or in some notes, etc, etc, actually these are not artistic. When you are writing down, don't consider yourself to be a student of class 10 or class 12 or class 11 or 9, whatever it may be. Don't consider yourself as such. Rather, consider yourself as a master artist who is producing a master class work. Consider yourself as an artist, because in the writing session, what's the demand? The demand is your artistic self. So the first point is be colloquial. The second point is make it picturesque, make it live. The third point is don't indulge into any complex or compound sentence. The fourth point is you must produce very simple sentences. And the fifth point is make your description vivid. So these would make your letter. These would make a successful personal letter for you. So follow them. You have the comment section where you may ask me where if you need any clarification, if you need a detailed discussion over any point, you may write it down there. And I would try my best to discuss it in live session or in some other videos. So like it, share it, stay with us. We'll return very soon with another fresh video regarding literature or grammar of English language.